Friends, welcome to my channel ELS, English Literature Studies with Core Harpreet. As you see on the screen, today I will discuss about famous sonneteers, Earl of Surrey, Sir Philip Sidney, Edmund Spenser, and minor sonneteers also. I have one dedicated video on Earl of Surrey named as Sonnet and Earl of Surrey, and one more video on Earl of Surrey in which I have discussed him as a founder of Renaissance poetry. And talking about Sidney, one video on Sir Philip Sidney's style of writing, and one video on Edmund Spenser's Amorothy also. You can check those links. I will give the links in the description box. You can check those videos also. That will be very helpful. And so let us start with today's video. Firstly, let me explain what is sonnet. And to know more about sonnet, if you want more detail or more explanation, you can watch my video on sonnet, in which I have discussed about sonnet, who is the father of sonnet, and about the origin of sonnet. You can also check that video. So let us start with today's video. Sonnet is a poem of 14 lines, each line being an iambic pentameter. There are two types of sonnet, Italian or Petrarchan, and second type is English or Shakespearean. The type of sonnet is determined by its rhyming scheme. Each line of a sonnet is divided into 10 syllables and 5 iambs. Petrarch has been widely accepted as the father of sonnet. Sonnet is popular as it shows a great ability to adapt to different needs and purposes. This is the reason why sonnet is popular, because it shows a great ability to adapt to different needs and different purposes. Sonnets have love, politics, nature, death as its main themes and subjects. Next is today's topic, main topic. First sonneteer is Earl of Surrey. He continued the vogue of writing, but he gave a new turn to sonnets. Instead of following Petrarchan model, Earl of Surrey preferred a new form, which was later on used by Shakespeare, with ease and grace. Surrey's sonnets are sonnets written to Lady Elizabeth Fitzgerald. These sonnets are characterized by a note of melancholy and sadness. His sonnets embody in their structure line the love lore cries of the poet's hearts. His sonnets of 14 lines are divided into 4 units, that is 3 quatrains and the ending couplet. And the rhyme scheme is ABAB, CDCD, EFEF, that is for 3 quatrains. And for the ending couplet, the rhyme scheme is GGG. Or second is ABAB, 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 for the 3 quatrains, and for the ending couplet it is CC. Surrey's sonnets embody tenderness, grace, lyrical melody, and genuine sentiments. These are the characteristics of Earl of Surrey's sonnets. Surrey's sonnets embody tenderness, grace, lyrical melody, and genuine sentiments, which were absent in Wyatt's sonnets. Surrey also wrote impersonal sonnets marked by cynicism and style. After the publication of Tottel's Miscellany, for many years sonnet was neglected. After it, the term sonnet was implied to lyrics, which were not of 14 lines. It was Thomas Watson who recalled the attention of the people to sonnet. He published his collection of work in 1882 when he was composing Astrophil and Stella. So the popular vogue began with Sidney. At this time, a fresh sonneting impulse came from France. And Elizabethan sonneteers drew inspiration from French sonneteers such as Ronsard, who is the prince of poets, and Philippe Desportes, who is model for the late Elizabethan poets. And Elizabethan sonneteers drew inspiration from these French sonneteers, who appeared more modern and effective than Petrarch. This is about Earl of Surrey. Next, I will discuss about Sir Philip Sidney. Sir Philip Sidney opened the gate of sonneteering in England. Sidney's most famous work is Astrophil and Stella, containing 108 sonnets and 11 songs. In it, Sidney told about the unrequited love for Penelope, just as Petrarch has told about his unsuccessful love for Laura, who is the beloved of this Italian poet. Right? Sidney's sonnet sequence is half real and half conventional. His sonnets reveal true lyrical emotion and mere literary prose work. There is a fusion of passions in his sonnets. We come across with fine poetical touches, flashes of beauty, notes of passion, and unforgettable phrases in his sonnets. His sonnets are first direct experiences of an intimate personal experience. What Charles M. says about Sidney, he says, Sidney's sonnets are not rich in words only, but also invoke an unlocalized feeling These are full, material and circumstantiated. There are obvious instances where Sidney seems to be writing after Petrarchan formula and his traditional apostrophes like to sleep, to night, to moon, even to his mistress dog resemble the apostrophe of foreign sonneteers and cannot be said original. In conclusion, we can say that Spenser follows a set tradition, but Sidney's sonnets are different from both formulas. It does not always adhere to the same pattern. In most of his sonnets, the rhyme scheme is ABBA, ABBA, CDC, CDC, whereas in others, it is ABAB instead of Petrarchan ABBA. Next sonnet I will discuss, that is Edmund Spenser. So let us read about Spenser. For centuries, Petrarchan and Shakespeare sonnets have been associated with love poetry. These poems express a passionate devotion to a woman. On the other hand, Spenser meant every word he penned. His Amorati comprises 88 sonnets in which he celebrates his coming marriage to his beloved Elizabeth Boyle. He immortalized his true love by giving the sonnet a fresh purpose and form. Like other sonneteers, Spenser's sonnets also contain 14 lines of iambic pentameter, meaning there are 5 iambic feet or iambs per line. However, his rhyme scheme and the manner in which he decided to divide these lines distinguish his form from the other sonneteers. The rhyme scheme he chose was ABAB, BCBC, CDCDEE, which lately came to be known as Spenserian sonnet. In conclusion, we can say that though there is absence of general passion in his sonnets, yet we cannot help to admire the sonnets because they represent the best traditions of Elizabethan sonnets. Now let us talk about minor sonneteers. Hardly there is a poet of 1590s who had not tried his hand at sonnets and addressed it to a mistress, whether real or imaginary. And these are Samuel Daniel, Henry Constable, Watson and Barnes. First is Samuel Daniel. I will discuss in brief because otherwise this video is already very lengthy video. And let us start with Samuel Daniel. He set an example to Shakespeare in treating the sonnet as a stanza. Second is Henry Constable. He is known particularly for Dinah, one of the first English sonnet sequences. Third is Thomas Watson. He influenced a generation of English writers, including Shakespeare. His unusual 18-line sonnets were influential, although the form was not generally imitated. Barney Barnes, known for his Petrarchan love sonnets, he is opposite of Samuel Daniel. He is forceful and copious, but harsh and indiscreet in his diction. So friends, this is all about my today's video. I've tried to explain my views on these sonneteers, but this is a full-fledged video. I hope you will like my today's video, and if you like it, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel. And if you're new on my channel, please hit the bell button to get notifications for upcoming videos. Thanks a lot for watching.